Hi, welcome back everybody to day three of the Plone Conference 2021. I am here with Alex Medesan, who will be speaking to us about advanced citations with Zotero and OpenAire and Plone 6.
Okay. Thank you for the introduction. So, my work in Plone is mainly concerning Volto and features regarding add-ons. Mainly, I've been working with for developing the Zotero citations and footnotes. And let's begin with a short reminder of what Zotero is and how it looked last year when I held a similar presentation. So, Zotero is a library that where you can store articles and books. It also has, in its structure, it has collections that can be nested. And if you want to use this feature, the addon that I created, you have to make sure to have a collection where all outside goes, which is what is going to be happening with our component, with our add-on. Yeah, we'll see about that later. So how do we use it? In site setup, we have to make sure two things happen. One of them, the API part is installed, so you can see from this. And then the second one, in the add-ons configuration, I have to configure something. So for example, the Zotero URL that has the user ID, API key, the default collection that I was saying, talking about, and then citation style. This can be either an URL for the case that one of the, that the desired citation style is not on their website. They have about 25,000. So I don't know why there are so many, but yeah, in our case, it wasn't there. Okay, so how it was last year. For example, my simple article, you want to create a citation. Also, this is a Slate add-on that is working together with the footnote pattern. So there are the two on the right, and the Zotero is the notebook one. We see a sidebar on the right, and this pulls from Zotero the collections and the items that we saw previously. When we preview, we actually download it from Zotero and we can use it. This creates decoration on the index that shows if the citation has been added. Let's have another one. These are the connections that I was saying. This is another one. Okay, let's add a new row. And here we can see the actual reference block. And we can see all the references. Like we are used to, for example, in Wikipedia. One thing that we had the last year is showing the citation as a popover, and it's the same thing as on the in the footnotes part. If we save, we see it. Okay, let's have another one. Another thing that we had last year is the possibility to search. For example, if you don't know in which of the collections an article is, or if it, you know it's not in your Zotero, we also had the OpenAire. We also get from that API and loading more data. You can see it has publication data and research data. So different entities, but we treat them the same way. Okay, so if we use one of these that we get from the from OpenAIR, so yeah, you see it, and it's the same situation style that we wanted, and this will be added in Zotero, and we can use it. So this is first added to Zotero, and then we request it from Zotero in the citation style that we wanted. So this is Pedro H. Brown Talion. And now we look for it to see. So remember, it, mine was, the collection name was where all outside goes. So alphabetically, it's not in the first number results, in the second. And then here it's also not in the first time results. And now we have no results. And then we can see it is the amount of it. Okay. Another thing that we had was footnotes. Now it looks a little different, but mainly you write text and then it will be added at the bottom of the footnote. So the this add-on is working on top of footnotes. So the footnotes considers that everything is like a footnote. So we see all of them together. Citations is what they use cite, and footnotes is your own notes. So it has the tag element, and yeah, you see it looks a little different to those terms. So another thing that we had that we now have that we didn't have last year was searching by author name. Zotero by default does this. It searches everything you want to find. It searches through title, author, and publication, I think. But for OpenAI, you have to use a different API. And I do that and I combine all the results. You see that it's in the title for these results. And if we find one that has it as just the author. Yeah, it's Federica Turco. It's there, and this one under that. Let's see. Yeah, that's good. So this is new. So it's requested by the file. Okay, and something, so that was new. What we had last year, it was also searched by DOI. So if we just enter the DOI, it shows the element, it's the same DOI. Okay. So the footnotes are treated the same way as the citation. You see the drop down with the element, and if you click on it, it will take you to the reference part, although it's the same thing, but it's a functionality. And then if we click on the return arrow on the bottom, it will take you to the element, highlight the element that is referencing that citation that references both. Okay, so what is new? So as you probably saw, there is a delete icon there. And this is because you cannot mount. So this is the main thing that I created this year, is adding multiple citations. Let's add another one. So one thing, I added two of them that were already added. So as you can see as a result, so this is, you have the three indices that show where in the reference block you have those citations, and also in the reference book, the ones that are added twice, they get an A and a B and a C, and for how many times they're referenced. Otherwise, if it's only once, it has a return. Yeah, then the dummy has it and then publishing has the Alexandru copy written, and essentially has the Risanato, which is also here in the publishing. Okay, another thing that we can do also, okay, let's have a moment. Okay, so this is, by the way, this is backwards compatible. So all the references that were done before, they work just as fine. The way I did that is all the new references that you add to an element, or if you add them to a new element, so an existing element, you want to add multiple, or a new element which works, which you create now with a new add-on, it works to be exactly the same way. So it's basically all the, you get one references and everything else is in an extra box. So this creates a problem. Potential problem is, for example, we can delete them. The problem is what happens if you delete the first one. So yeah, first of all, if you delete any of them, you see that the Risanato has been changed. It disappears from the popover and the reference gets the arrow instead of the A and B. Yeah, this still, Alexandru, this is the first one. So this contains all the others. So what happens if you delete the first one? Well, basically, all others will be, the first one in the extra will take its place. So it works, you see the Alexandru loses the AB, just gets the arrow, meaning it's only one, and it gets the sign. So for existing, nothing has changed because the object looks the same and the everything, the, all the new, all the new extra citations are adding an extra file, so in an extra property. The same is for footnotes. Footnotes can also have multiple footnotes and they work. They work the same. So if you save, you see the learn has added a 6 and a 7. This, yeah, this is a footnote is used twice, so it also gets an A and B. They are compared by text. So that's how it knows that it has been used again. For Zotero, we have a Zotero ID, which is easier than comparing the text. But for example, now that I deleted one, you see it suggested in the dropdown. So this gathers all footnotes. Even if they're referenced multiple times, it will know that it's only one footnote and will add it here. So they're all unique suggestions that you can either click or write and it will know. So if we delete it, the same thing, it adjusts it, it adjusts it. Now we write. So this is the same problem. What if we delete the first one? Does the same thing. The other, the new one takes its place and it keeps the same structure. You see everything is referenced only once and the new footnote lost its A and B. Another thing that we added this year, so it was the multiple citations and multiple footnotes. Another functionality was the ability to copy and paste, which is something that happens. You see, dummy knows that it's the first, which is copied the Alexandru copy rating, and Alexandru copy rated get an AMD, which means it's copied. And then a C, if you paste it another time. Okay. Same thing is happening with the footnotes. If you paste this, this is a footnote that an AMD. and the C. So it's the same functionality for both. This is, although footnotes and Zotero, they have a bit of a different structure. The main work for this was done on the footnote side. So Zotero, in the structure of how you implement the Zotero add-on, you say it's depending on footnotes, and most of the block and the render component is actually saying that it's the one from the footnote. So I'm actually writing it once. And that goes for footnotes, goes for Zotero also. So let's add a group. Groups, they have its own, they can have its own context, let's say, and see if it still works, because before that was the easy part, it's just the text. And now let's make it even more complicated and add another group inside of the group and just paste it outside and see if it works. So, first of all, first let's add the one that's already existing and see if it's modifies in any way. So we see it says it's the first one, and in the footnote we see a D here, and in the group, in the group, let's add one that also existed. You see it says 2 and 1. Now to this another, the first one is actually the second in the footnotes. And then E appeared for Alexandru and the B for Lisana. It also is aware of the outside. Let's test it for, you see it suggested footnotes. We'll see that footnotes is the only one in the footnotes. We'll write another one. Same thing for footnotes. Let's see that it's the seventh and the 607th. And you see the footnotes is four times already used. Okay, next we will want to add a similar structure, which would be the accordions, and let's see how it interacts with those. So put a title. This should be a predictable, normal way of using it. You put some text inside and try to reference it. Yeah. Let's add something new. Okay, so it knows that this is new. It says the 8. You see it already, it has been used once. So how do these two interact? You open it. It says it's the last one, but if you close this, what happens if you want to reference the word that is in a closed accordion? Well, it just opens the accordion and it highlights the word. Okay, so another thing that we can do is, for example, we want to add some text and use property that can happen in real scenarios, which is you want to write a text and then cite some works, but you don't want to have all the citations that are not regarding that specific part of text. So it's like creating it in a bubble. let's situation for this one. Let's use an existing one. Okay, and one thing that we want to, okay, so we will add another block of footnotes to see this. So what we see now is the footnotes blocks that shows only these two. So this is because on the right, it's a Volto config that says entire document. We don't check it, it shows only in this context. One thing that can happen is users removing the footnotes block and adding it in an accordion, so you don't see it if you don't need it. So right now it doesn't show anything because there is nothing there. So you have to click the entire document. And let's see if I use. So the reference block is always closed if you don't need, because we also have the purple. Sure. Yeah, you have everything. So let's say we want to show the first. As you can see, it opens the accordion and the other way around. If you click on the citation, it opens the references. So that's mainly what I have for this presentation. Another thing is that I didn't show, there were some changes and some adaptation needs to be done. It also works in metadata, is aware of that. Hopefully next year I will come with another even better add-on. So, thank you.
Thank you for providing us with such an interesting talk about advanced citations. If you would like to continue the conversation, I will post the Jitsi in the Track 1 Slack channel. And thanks again for presenting today.